Absolutely. Yes, guys, welcome back, guys, to my channel. So many of you keep emailing me and asking me about different styles and different types of traders, okay? And some people are asking me what type of trader I am, you know, and then people are asking what type of traders you are, you know, and there's the thing, okay? So what type of trader are you? If you're still confused about different types of traders and why they're being named as different type of traders, this video is gonna help you and gonna identify finally what type of trader are you. Are you a day trader? Are you a swing trader, fundamental trader, or are you a technical trader? Or are you a long trader, or are you a different type of trader? So this video is gonna conclude this, and so watch this video until the end because it should answer this question, and it's really, really important for you to understand what type of trader you are. You know, it's gonna help you, you know, identify different trends, and it's gonna mostly help you identify your style of trading, and then you will be able to pursue those types of strategies or those types of time frames, you know, and those types of pattern trading tactics. So make sure, guys, you watch this video until the end. So let's get started. Right, so let's jump right into it. So are you a day trader, swing trader, fundamental trader, technical trader, or long-term trader, or you are a different type? So who is a day trader? Right, so they look for multiple daily trades, they seek profits from small market movements, they're not interested in overnight risk, and they aim to, in over 10 to 20 positions a day. So, well, the mostly day traders, not 20 positions, this is from the, you know, from other news portal, you know, that's, you know, reliable. But, especially speaking, I don't agree that the people place 20 trades a day, no. People, yeah, day traders tend to place, I would say, up to 10 trades a day. People don't place 20 trades a day, and, you know, because the more trades you play, you trade, the more risk there is. And the trading is not quantity over quality. Day trading is quality over quantity. It's always about being able to see that opportunity to present themselves, and then we as a traders, we pursue that opportunity and we jump into the markets and we place the trade. Right, so the technical trader or technical analyst seeks to utilize historical price trends to determine future price action. Technical traders adhere to the notion that history normally repeats itself. You know, that's something I usually tell you. History repeats itself, and history does repeat itself. Ignoring much of the noise in the markets that can be created from breaking news, earning reports, or boredom. Boardroom instability, etc. And I can continue. So yeah, so well, technical trader is different from the pattern trader. Is kind of a pattern trader, but technical traders, basically speaking, they don't take into consideration fundamental news. Well, the news we look at, when we look at other market news. So ask the question: are you analyzing or are you taking into consideration any fundamental news or any news that are being released? You know, depends what you trade. If you trade forex markets, so are you taking fundamental forex news into consideration or not? Or are you just simply looking at the charts and looking for trading opportunities by looking at the charts? So this is the question you should ask yourself. So are you a technical trader? Okay, so next one. So the swing traders look to get the most out of price swings in the markets when prices are definitive trend, and also seek to spot the reversal in prices. Swing traders are technical in nature, choosing largely to ignore the noise of breaking news or company earnings, you know, company earning reports, to focus especially on price action and trends. So the swing trader and the technical trader, now you can see the similarities. So they are, again, they're not focusing much on fundamentals, you know, than other traders. You know that I do focus on fundamentals, again, depends what I trade. Of course, if I see that the dollar is going up, then I read the news and I know that, wow, the news are telling me that the dollar is going up. What does it mean? It means that the gold goes down, of course, and vice versa. Then it means that, of course, I should take that news report in my brain, and I know that the gold dollar goes up, I should place gold sell trades. I should short gold. So I mean, you know, and now you can see that, you know, now you can see, and it should make sense, right? So the swing traders. So again, for the swing traders, You know, they don't necessarily open trade in the morning and close in the next couple of hours. No, the swing traders could close trade after several days, you know, even up to a week or more than a week, up to a couple of weeks, you know. So swing traders are different type of traders, and that's why they don't really, you know, take into consideration that, you know, any of the, you know, the fundamental noise, if you like. But that's really, really risky, and swing traders, you know, it's really, really risky trading, you know, trading style to have, because, as you know, what's driving the markets? Markets are not just driven, you know, by themselves, you know, up and down by fun. No, markets are being driven by the fundamentals, okay? So the fundamental news. And you can just see that on investing.com, how the markets are being driven. Next one, so the fundamental trader. Now, the opposite, okay? So the fundamental trader seeks to analyze the true value of an asset, be it a share, currency, or metal, highlighting the potential trading opportunity when the underlying price in the market for the asset indicates if the prices are overvalued or undervalued. And this is exactly what we are doing, okay? So, but again, you know what trader I am. I'm a pattern trader that takes into consideration the fundamental news. So I do take a look at if something is being undervalued or overvalued, and how we do that by losing indicators. You know, Bollinger Bands, MACD, RSI. Well, RSI is a volume indicator by itself, but you don't use them as a standalone indicators because you're gonna lose, which I proved you many times. Make sure you use support resistance and then a couple of indicators, and make sure you combine them together to make the trading system. Well, this is not trading system, but you know what I'm talking about, right? Yes, so let's continue on. So, and the long-term trader. So long-term traders, and the long-term trader typically adapts a buying and holding, a buy and hold strategy, which essentially means buying an asset such as share and holding onto an asset for a number of years until it increases in value. Well, long-term trading is completely different trading, and long-term traders are well, statistically speaking, long-term traders are older generation people, you know. I haven't, you know, and even in my, you know, that I have Forex Trading Academy, you know, we also trade the metals, silver, gold, and other commodities, oil. And the thing is this, that what I've seen, you know, most of my traders in my academy are short-term traders. There are day traders and fundamental traders and swing traders. I don't have many long-term traders. That's interesting, okay? Interesting. But yes, I will tell you straight away, I don't have many long-term traders as students in my academy. Most traders are short-term traders for some reason. And interesting enough, I'm the same. I don't hold, and I don't recommend to you to hold any, you know, anything for longer term, because nothing nowadays has a guarantee. There are no guarantees for anything whatsoever, you know. You know, that's why it's better to trade safely rather than to be sorry, right? I mean, again, it should make sense. Again, there's no magic in that sense. So, yeah. So, long-term traders, for example, when it comes to... I'm not a long-term trader, but when it comes to Bitcoin, I'm a long-term hodler. Yeah. You know, when it comes to Bitcoin, I am not short-term or day trader in Bitcoin. Because if you're a Bitcoin day trader, you're going to lose money. In that sense, I can say that, yes, when it comes to Forex, I'm a day trader, pattern trader, that who takes into consideration fundamental news. But when it comes to cryptocurrency investment, I'm a long-term trader. Yeah, that's what it is. I'm sorry about that, but that's what it is. You know, and that's what I'm always telling you guys, don't trade Bitcoin for short term, because you're going to lose. You know, you can win, and then you're going to lose, because exchanges are charging crazy commissions, you know. So make sure you understand that. Right, so thank you for watching this video. Please like and subscribe. And most importantly, remember, there is no magic in trading. You know, education and practice is the key for long-term success. If you have any questions or any assistance, or if you need any general help in trading, you're always welcome to email me at incomementorbox@gmail.com. And also, if you want to become a successful online trader from home, you're always welcome to join my academy and follow my daily trades. Thank you guys for watching this video. Please like and subscribe, and see you again next time. Bye.